Hi, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. The atmosphere is a protective layer of gases that surrounds Earth. It acts as a protective shield against harmful elements in the environment. If the Earth were the size of an apple, our atmosphere would be only as thick as the apple's skin. The atmosphere is made up of 78% nitrogen, 21% oxygen, and 1% other gases. The Earth's atmosphere blocks out some of the harmful radiation from the sun. This keeps us alive and helps us to survive. At the same time, the Earth is kept warm by a process known as the greenhouse effect. The atmosphere is split into five main layers. The troposphere is the lowest layer, beginning at the Earth's surface and continuing upward to an average of 10 kilometers. We live in this part of the atmosphere, and almost all weather occurs here. Because the troposphere contains 99% of the water in the atmosphere, most clouds form there. As you get higher in the troposphere, the air gets colder. Next is the stratosphere, which extends from the top of the troposphere to about 50 kilometers from the Earth's surface. The stratosphere contains the ozone layer, which absorbs and converts high-intensity UV radiation into heat. In the stratosphere, the air actually gets warmer the higher you go. Above the stratosphere is the mesosphere, which continues upwards to a height approximately 80 kilometers from the Earth's surface. The majority of meteors burn up in the mesosphere. The mesosphere is the atmosphere's coldest layer. Temperatures can drop as low as minus 100 degrees Celsius in the mesosphere layer. The next part of what is thought to be the Earth's atmosphere is the thermosphere. Thermosphere extends from the mesosphere to a height between 500 and 1,000 kilometers from the Earth's surface. In this layer, temperatures increase with altitude due to the very low density of molecules found here. It is both cloud and water vapor free. Temperatures can vary from between 500 and 2,000 degrees Celsius or higher. The aurora borealis and aurora australis are sometimes seen here. The International Space Station orbits in the thermosphere. The final layer of the Earth's atmosphere is exosphere. The exosphere is the outermost layer of the atmosphere. It extends from the thermosphere to 10,000 kilometers, some say to 190,000 kilometers, which is roughly halfway to the moon. There is no defined upper boundary because of how gradually it fades into the vacuum of outer space. The sun strikes the exosphere first. This causes the sunlight to heat the low-density air. It's so hot that temperatures can reach up to 2,000 degrees Celsius or more. Most satellites orbit in the exosphere. For example, GPS, telecommunications, and weather satellites circle the Earth in the exosphere. There's no weather at all in the exosphere. The aurora borealis and aurora australis are sometimes seen in its lowest part. Not all scientists agree that the exosphere is really a part of the atmosphere. Some scientists consider the thermosphere is the uppermost part of the Earth's atmosphere and think that the exosphere is really just part of space. However, other scientists do consider the exosphere part of our planet's atmosphere. Also, we must mention an interesting layer called the ionosphere. The ionosphere is the ionized part of the upper atmosphere of Earth, from about 50 kilometers to 965 kilometers above sea level, a region that includes the thermosphere and parts of the mesosphere and exosphere. The ionosphere is important because it reflects and modifies radio waves used for communication and navigation. It's a very active part of the atmosphere, and it grows and shrinks depending on the energy it absorbs from the sun. I hope that you now know what the layers of the Earth's atmosphere are. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share this video. Watch the rest of my videos from my YouTube channel. Please consider to support me on Patreon. Thanks very much. See you on the next video.